All the giants introduced their new chipset this year. Qualcomm introduced the Snapdragon 8 Elite, which is used in the Xiaomi 15 unit we have here. MediaTek introduced Dimensity 9400, which is on the Vivo X200 Pro unit that I directly imported from Hong Kong. Apple introduced the A18 Pro on the iPhone 16 Pro Max. We also have the last Tensor chipset from Google on the Pixel 9 unit. The last Exynos chipset, which is the Exynos 2400, is also on the Samsung Galaxy S24 Exynos variant. I am Mo, and I bought all of these phones with my own money. The Xiaomi and Vivo are directly imported from Hong Kong, and I will put the link to where I got them from in the description. Before we start the comparison, I should make a big disclaimer. The only proper way to compare the chipsets with the same exact hardware where only the chipset is different. Otherwise, we are not doing a proper A/B test, since there are too many variables. These phones have different cooling chambers, RAM, and storage speed, but I will try my best to keep all other conditions the same. Also, the phones have different form factors, so I will refrain from comparing the temperatures of the phones like my other tests, since it can be misleading. I'm also picking tests that would not put the phones on thermal throttling on purpose, since that can also affect the benchmark scores. Each phone can get a score from 1 to 5 per category, based on their placement on the test. We'll start the Adobe Rush export test. Adobe Rush is a video editing app from Adobe. Using the phones, we are exporting the same standard footage of around 1 minute in 4K 30 frames per second resolution. We are looking to see how long each phone takes to export this footage. Apple products and Apple Silicon chipsets are known for being highly optimized for video and photo editing. And that's why I migrated from Windows to Mac after I started this YouTube channel this year. It is not surprising that the iPhone 16 Pro Max finished the export first in only 53 seconds. It is mind-blowing how fast the phones have gotten. If Apple added something like DeX to their smartphones, that would be a game changer. Xiaomi 15 finished second in 1 minute and 27 seconds. It was quickly followed by Vivo X200 Pro in 1 minute and 36 seconds. Google Pixel 9 took its time to finish the export, and it was done after 2 minutes and 16 seconds, more than double compared to the iPhone 16 Pro Max. Galaxy S24 with Exynos 2400 was a bit disappointing, and the task was finished in 4 minutes and 27 seconds. Therefore, A18 Pro got 5 points, Snapdragon Elite got 4, Dimensity got 3, Tensor got 2, and Exynos got 1. For the second test, I decided to test exporting pictures using Adobe Lightroom. As I mentioned, I only pick a small number of images so the phones don't get above 40 degrees Celsius, which is the typical throttling temperature for most phones. The iPhone finished the task first after only 1 minute and 20 seconds. Dimensity finished close to the iPhone after 1 minute and 32 seconds. Surprisingly, the Snapdragon 8 Elite took some time, finishing in 1 minute and 45 seconds, and got third place. Exynos was faster than the Tensor this time, and completed the task in 2 minutes and 22 seconds. The Tensor took a long time and finished in 2 minutes and 41 seconds. I understand many folks say that the Tensor is enough for daily tasks, but as a person who often uses Adobe Lightroom on my phone, I prefer to get a flagship quality for the flagship price that Google asked for Tensor G4. For video and photo editing, A18 Pro received 10 points, Dimensity and Snapdragon received 7, and Tensor and Exynos received 3. After this test, I moved to benchmarks. I started with Geekbench 6, which focuses on CPU performance. This benchmark calculates tasks important for computational photography, such as object detection, background blur, horizontal detection, and other daily routines like text processing. iPhone with A18 Pro got the best single core score, followed by Snapdragon, then Dimensity 9400. Exynos single core was slightly better than Tensor's. For multi-core, the iPhone with A18 Pro again got the best score, followed by the Snapdragon 8 Elite and Dimensity 9400. Due to a higher number of cores, Exynos got a much better score than Tensor this time. Here, A18 Pro again got 10 points. Dimensity 9400 got 6, Qualcomm Snapdragon 8 Elite got 8, Tensor only got 2 points, basically points for participation and finishing the tasks, and Exynos got 4. After running the Geekbench benchmark, I moved to Antutu 1. In my opinion, the Antutu benchmark is more comprehensive and includes more tests in different conditions. However, we should also be more precise in interpreting it since, in the calculation, the memory and UX are also getting points, which can be more related to the phone's model and are not only related to the chipset. Here, Dimensity 9400 won the round with a score of 2.6 million. Snapdragon Elite came second with 2.4 million, followed by 1.8 million from A18 Pro. Exynos got a respectable 1.6 million, which is okay considering it is last generation chipset. Tensor got only 1 million, not even half of the new Snapdragon and Dimensity. The scores for the CPU and GPU parts of Antutu results are the same, which makes our lives easier. This time, 18 Pro got 6 points, Dimensity got all 10 points, Snapdragon got 8, Tensor got 2 points for participation, and Exynos got 4. These days, AI is a big topic with Galaxy AI, Gemini, and Apple Intelligence. Hence, I decided to include the Geekbench AI test. A critical note here, the benchmark for Android is TensorFlow Lite, but for iOS, it uses CoreML. They are fundamentally different libraries. TensorFlow is a known machine learning library, while CoreML is only for iOS. Hence, we cannot compare these scores directly. For CPU, Exynos got the best score. It is not surprising since machine learning algorithms heavily depends on multithreading, and Exynos gets more cores. Snapdragon and Dimensity got similar scores, and Tensor got last. Here, I will give Exynos and A18 Pro a score of 5, Snapdragon and Dimensity 4, and Tensor 1. I ran the same test, but it was on GPU this time. Again, Exynos dominated this round. Snapdragon followed it, which got a much better half precision and quantized score than Dimensity. Again, please note that the Apple's score is not comparable to the rest. Here the total score for Apple is 10. Dimensity gets 7, Snapdragon gets 8, Tensor gets 2 points for participation and being a good boy. And Exynos surprised us all and will take 10 points home. We will then move to the graphics with 3D Mark benchmarks. I particularly like this benchmark, one of the closest benchmarks to reality when playing video games. I will first run the wildlife stress test. I won't run the 20 times loop like usual, since as I mentioned before, I don't plan to put the phones on thermal throttling. In the test, Dimensity got the best score. The second place was for Snapdragon 8 Elite. Apple A18 Pro got third place, followed by Exynos and Tensor, which came last. At this point, Tensor should be relegated to the best mid-range chipset category. For the second part of the GPU test, I ran the SolarBay 3D Mark benchmark, focusing on ray tracing. Ray tracing is not popular yet on mobile phones, but it is a chipset capability that we can put to the test. The Tensor does not support ray tracing, so the usual participation score won't be obtained this time. This time, like the last one, Dimensity won with the highest score, followed by Snapdragon. Exynos got the third place, and A18 Pro was a close fourth. Tensor did not finish the task. Therefore, the total score for the GPU is 5 points for A18 Pro, 10 points for Dimensity, 8 points for Snapdragon, 1 point for Tensor, and 5 points for Exynos. In total, Dimensity won the battle by getting the most points, while the A18 Pro was a close second, and Snapdragon 8 Elite was a close third. Exynos was fourth, but that's understandable as it is one generation behind. Tensor is the new generation, but we are getting a similar performance as 2 to 3 years ago. In video and photo editing, the A18 Pro got the highest score and won without any issues. Again, in the CPU comparison using Geekbench, the A18 Pro got the best score, followed by Snapdragon Elite. In the Geekbench AI department, Exynos surprised us and got the best score, but unfortunately, we had to exclude this category. In Antutu, Dimensity won the match. The same goes for the 3D Mark benchmark, where Dimensity got the most points and Snapdragon got second. The normalized scores are shown in the radial chart. I excluded the AR part since the iOS and Android parts were incomparable. This chart shows the Snapdragon in red and Dimensity in orange have bigger areas than the A18 Pro in gray, even though the A18 Pro wins in a couple of categories. Exynos in blue is almost inside all the giants, and Tensor in green struggles even more. If you enjoyed this video, you will also enjoy the battery comparison of A18 versus Exynos and Snapdragon versus Tensor. Thanks for tuning into Tecmo, and I will see you in the next one.